Hallelujah. Happy New Month to everybody. We want to appreciate the name of the Lord for giving us the grace again to meet all the power of second ambassadors. And gradually, we are moving to the middle of the year. We want to thank God for His faithfulness in keeping us alive. And I pray that in the name of Jesus, the tarrying is coming. It will see us to the end of the year in Jesus' name. And so once again, Happy New Month to everybody. And today, by the grace of God, we are dealing with another interesting topic, and that has to that deals with us checking the way we are living our lives, particularly as God's children at this same time. And so today, by God's grace, our topic is divine positioning. Divine positioning. And our text, I take it from the book of Matthew chapter 26 and chapter 27, verse 1 to 5, Luke chapter 1 from verse 26 to 38, and 2 Timothy chapter 3 from verse 16 to 17. Matthew chapter 26 from to chapter 27, verse 1 to 5, Luke chapter 1 from verse 26 to 38, and 2 Timothy chapter 3 from verse 16 to 17. Please let us pray. Excellent Jehovah, we want to thank you for the grace and privilege you have given unto us, and to be among those that will see the fifth month in the year 2021. We appreciate you for all you have done for us in the year, and even as one of the ambassadors. Father, we say, let your name be glorified in our lives in Jesus' name. We pray, God, that as we go into today's discussion, please take control. Holy Spirit, so pretend over everything that we are discussing in Jesus' name. And in the end, let all glory be unto your name. Thank you because you have answered. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. And so, like I mentioned to us earlier, our topic is divine positioning. I'd like us to understand that as students, adults, young, no matter our age category, all of us have read books before. But then for me, the book I found to be the most important in human history is the Bible. And why do I say this? Because the Bible itself, of course, it's a book of the six, it's known as the scriptures, and then we see the six books that are from Genesis to Revelation. But then if you look at the kind of lives that the Bible in a way has transformed, we have the Bible has influenced a lot of lives, millions of lives, and for me, I see it as a very perfect book for everybody. And so if you are here to get the Bible, I want to encourage you to do so today. And because I assure you, by the time you study it, of course, with the Spirit of God leading you, you will enjoy the best of it. And so today, by the grace of God, like I said earlier, our topic is divine positioning. And I would like us to understand that the Bible, as we have seen in the book of 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16, was actually from the inspiration of God. And then in that particular text, we are made to understand the purpose of God giving us the scriptures, and then like I said to us earlier, that is from God's inspiration, that is God breathed, and then it's useful, it's profitable for doctrine, it's to teach us, it's for reproof, that is to rebuke us if we are doing anything that is wrong, for correction, for us to be able to correct our ways, and then for instruction in righteousness. And then, like I've made us understand earlier, that the scripture itself, I was talking about the Bible, has a lot of books, and we call them books. That's talking about Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, and then to John, and then Revelation, which are the last two books. And talking about this Bible itself, there are different characters that the Bible talks about. There are different characters in this great book. We have the story of Abraham, King David, and the likes. For us to understand that as Christians, this Bible was actually written for our edification. And so today, by the grace of God, we are focusing on just two characters, and that's talking about Sister Mary and then Apostle Judas Iscariot. I would like us to understand the fact that when the Bible was being penned down for us to for it to bless our lives, the people, the characters involved, and didn't know that there will be something that will be called the Bible. They were just living their lives, and then their actions or inactions or their reactions to whatever happened to them were noted down for us to learn from. And so, like I said to us earlier, our focus today is on Sister Mary and Apostle Judas Iscariot. You want to argue if, or you may be surprised that Judas Iscariot is an apostle? Yes, he is. And because in the book of Mark chapter 3, that's talking from verse 13 to 15, the Bible makes us understand Jesus called unto himself the 12, and then he appointed them as apostles. So Judas Iscariot, who eventually betrayed the Lord Jesus Christ, is was also an apostle. So today, by the grace of God, our focus is on these three individuals. I'm talking about Sister Mary, that is the mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, and then Apostle Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot, who eventually betrayed the Lord Jesus. And so for the first character, talking about Sister Mary, and like we all know, is the mother of our Lord Jesus Christ, every year, particularly on December 25, we celebrate the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. All over the world, we celebrate that Jesus was born. But then, without the story of this woman, without the life of this particular woman, maybe that day might not be something that we all will have will take note of today. And so today, the first character I want to consider, like I mentioned earlier, is this Sister Mary. We want to look at what are those things that this woman did, and that we all can also learn from in divinely positioning ourselves and to be used by God. And the very first thing that this woman did was the fact that she stayed where God wanted her to stay. She was in Nazareth. If you look at the text, Luke chapter 1 from verse 26, found that when the angel of God was sent by God, God sent the angel to that place called Nazareth. So that means that assuming this woman was not in Nazareth, probably she might have missed it. So she stayed where God wanted her to stay. As well as the lesson here, that means that for you and I to be able to fulfill purpose, for you and I to be able to be all that God wants us to be, we need to stay where God desires us to stay. We need to do the kind of work that God wants us to work. We need to live where God wants us to live. We need to, do everything that God, we need to marry the kind of person God wants us to marry. I pray God will give us understanding in the name of Jesus. I wonder if anything about this woman was the fact that she was a virgin. Of course, some people can argue that she was not the only virgin there, but then virginity also qualified her to be that woman that will be the mother of our Lord Jesus Christ. That means that she kept herself only unto God. Brothers and sisters, I want us to understand that God has not compromised his standard. I will never do. So that means that living right, living holy, living righteously, there are God's way, or there are ways by which we can make ourselves, present ourselves as vessels of honor in the hands of God. So we need to understand the place of holiness as we work with this God. It's not just for us to claim that we are Christians or we are born Christians. It's for us to live holy. And of course, when we live holy, God himself knows that we are actually living righteously. I pray God will help us all in Jesus' name. Another thing that we can also learn from this woman is the fact that she was in the right relationship. And that text, Luke chapter 1, verse 27, we got to know how she had been betrothed to Brother Joseph. And then if you look at the genealogy that's written in the book of Matthew chapter 1, we see that Brother Joseph, in a way, has a link with King David. And of course, eventually, Brother Bartimaeus called Jesus thou son of David. So that means that this woman was in a right relationship. So that means that for you and I to be able to achieve all that God wants us to achieve in life, for us to be able to fulfill purpose, for us to be able to be all that God wants us to be, we need to be in the right relationship. And brothers and sisters, can I ask you that the marriage you are in, relationship you are in, and people you are interested with, are you sure you are in the right place? I pray God will help us in making the right decision regarding our relationship in Jesus' name. Then the fourth thing about this woman that we also need to learn from was the fact that she asked the right question. And in the book of Luke chapter 1 verse 34, when the angel appeared to her and told her everything that was going to happen, and she asked the angel, how will all of these things be? And saying that she was actually a virgin at that time. So she asked the right question, and the angel responded, he said, the power of the Most High shall overshadow thee. So that means that God is not saying we should just be following him without asking questions. When we need to ask questions, maybe there is a pattern in our family that we don't like, maybe there are things that are going on that seems to be like a puzzle to us. We need to ask God questions. We need to, ask questions and find answers from the scriptures, and also see the face of God in getting answers to those things. So asking questions is not bad, but then we must ensure that the question that we are asking are the right questions. And then the last thing that we want to talk about this woman that you and I can learn from today and divinely positioning ourselves to be vessels unto use in God's hand is the fact that she positioned herself in faith to receive the promise. Brothers and sisters, as we have noted that earlier in our previous lessons, that the Bible is a perfect book. Even as we have also established in today's message, that the Bible itself, for me, is the best book we can ever have in this world. And because it has a solution to every human challenge. There's nothing you are looking for in the Word of God or in the Bible that you will not find. And so this woman was able to position herself in faith to receive the promise. Brothers and sisters, concerning that thing you are looking up to God for, there's a word in the scripture that addresses that. There's a word in scripture that God has given us as a promise. And for instance, in Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 11, he said, you know, he's going to give us an expected end. So we can stand on that word. We can stand on that word. And that was what this woman did. This woman, you know, told the angel, he said, be it unto me according to thy word. So believing that the Bible is the word of God, you and I, we can take advantage of all the promises in the Bible, and I pray in the name of Jesus, these promises will work for us in Jesus' name. And then discussing the second character, and I've established was that Buddha Judas Iscariot was actually part of the 12 apostles. And so we want to also learn another way how he also positioned himself to be used by the devil. And the very first thing that affected this man, I want to call him man of God, but I'm somewhat careful to call him man of God. But then the first thing that affected the disciple was the fact that he was not watchful. And we can see that in the book of Matthew 26, verse 1 to 2. In all that he was doing, Jesus said it, everything, he knew what was written in the scriptures, he knew what had been written before concerning how Jesus was going to die and all that Jesus had been saying. But then he was not bothered by all of those things. He just wanted to do his own thing. He was not watchful. I pray that God will help us all and to be watchful as Christians in Jesus' name. Another thing that also affected the disciple was the fact that he allowed himself and his thought to be controlled by the devil. He left himself, he was just totally out for the devil. The devil took advantage of his ignorance. The devil took advantage of all his carelessness, and the devil was able to manipulate him, was able to push him around, and eventually that brought him an untimely death. I pray that will not be a portion in the name of Jesus. And then if you look at Matthew 26, verse 16, the Bible said that he actually planned all of this, for a while. Not that he betrayed Jesus in one day, no. He took him time to be able to carry out this particular thing that he did, this evil deed that he carried out. But then that points to the fact that for a while, this brother failed to have fellowship. He failed to have devotion. He failed to have his quiet time. Brothers and sisters, I want to emphasize the place of us having our devotion, the place of us having our quiet time, the place of us having fellowship with God. When was the last time you were in church? When was the last time you had Bible study? When was the last time you had prayer meeting? When was the last time you were in church? When was the last time you read your Bible yourself? When was the last time you had a personal time to pray with the Lord? I pray that in the name of Jesus, we will not end like Brother Judas in Jesus' name. But for us not to end like him, we need to ensure that we maintain our constant fellowship with God and also with the brethren. Another thing that also was disturbing about this disciple that he was the fact that he focused his mind on doing the wrong thing. Despite this, Jesus was so clear about it. Jesus was, he thought that Jesus or maybe did not make it clear to him. Jesus made it clear to everybody that woe to him, via which he would be betrayed. And Judas was also there, he had all of those warnings. But Jesus even said that it's like better for that person to have been born. Yet Jesus Iscariot did not change his mind. I pray in the name of Jesus that any power of the devil that to destroy us, to lead us onto to eternal damnation, the Lord Himself will deliver us from, and that plan in the name of Jesus. Another thing that this brother or this apostle also failed to address was the fact that he chose to go ahead with his plan rather than plead for mercy. At that time when they were dying with the Lord Jesus, all of them were asking if they were the one that would betray Jesus. And he himself, he also asked Jesus if he would be the one. And Jesus said, yes, he will be the one. At that point in time, I feel that he will plead for mercy, because although we know that somebody will definitely betray Jesus, I thought when Jesus said you are the one, that he will prostrate or he will just do everything to ensure that Jesus pardon him, and so that he will not do it. Jesus even prayed for him, so that Jesus prayed for Peter. But then this man did not do that. Rather than plead for mercy, he went ahead to do his own thing. I pray in the name of Jesus, any power from the pit of hell pushing us to do the wrong thing, the Lord will deliver us from such power in Jesus' name. And that thing that also saw to the end of this man in a very bad manner is the fact that his greed led him to embrace evil communications. When the other disciples were with Jesus, when they were learning at his master's feet, he was busy, talking with the high priest and every other people that wanted Jesus to die. He was busy interacting with them, he was busy negotiating with them. In fact, he even told them that anybody that he kisses, will be the person that they are to murder. That is Jesus Christ. He fell a lot into evil communication. And I pray that if there are any of our family or teenagers or youths that are all around, you know, are in the person that has been involved in communication. I pray that God himself will rescue such today in Jesus' name. And then again, another important thing that we also need to know about this disciple was the fact that he deceived himself for a long time. He pretended to be a follower. And not knowing that he was not a follower. He was just pretending that he was following Jesus. Meanwhile, he was after the money that he would gain. I pray that our service in God's fire will not be in vain in Jesus' name. And the reason why, the major reason why it's important for us to understand that Judas Iscariot was actually an apostle is the fact that for us to know that as Christians, devil has not given up on us. The devil that the Bible says that we should be careful because he's looking everywhere, looking for whom to devour. And the Bible also makes us understand his triple agenda, which is to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And so that means that as Christians, although we are born again, we still need to be careful of the tactics of the enemies. In fact, in the book of Ephesians, the Bible says that we should be watchful, that we should be careful of his schemes. I pray God will deliver us from all his tactics in Jesus' name. And then the last thing we should also need to learn from this apostle that died untimely was the fact that he allowed the devil to push him and to reward him with an untimely death. Judas Iscariot died before his time, and I pray that in the name of Jesus, that will not be our portion in Jesus' name. And so in summary, what we are saying is the fact that as Christians, we need to understand that this two individuals talking about Sister Mary and Apostle Iscariot, they actually position themselves to fulfill long time promises without their knowing, you know. Maybe was just living her life and she was just like every other youth, she was just like every other lady in her time. But then in a way she positioned herself to fulfill that long time promise. Because even from the Old Testament, from the book of Isaiah, they've told us that Messiah will be born and then it's going to be by virgin birth. So she, you know, unknowingly for her, she positioned herself and to be used by God. And then also talking about Apostle Judas Iscariot, Jesus of course was going to die, but then there was someone that would betray him. So he also indirectly positioned himself to fulfill that long time prophecy. And so that's why you and I, we need to be careful. We need to understand that those steps we are taking is either we are working in the will of God or we are going against the will of God. I pray that God will give us understanding as we go in the rest of the year in Jesus' name. But then before we go, I want us to consider the text. This is 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 20. Made us understand that there are vessels unto honor and then there are vessels unto honor. But then these vessels, of course, they are all in the house, but then some vessels are to honor and then the others are to dishonor. But then what makes us to qualify a vessel, you know, maybe to be of honor or to dishonor, is by the deeds of that particular vessel, by what that vessel, you know, is used for. So that means that by our actions, by all that we do, by our reactions, by the way we handle matters, we can actually, you know if we are vessels unto honor or vessels unto dishonor. But then what God desires us to be is to be vessels unto honor. And the only way, or let me say, the best way to be a vessel unto honor is by us living our own life, by us living righteously. And we can say that in 2 Timothy chapter 2, from verse 21 and to 22. So, in summary, this message is for us to be able to understand that as Christians, we need to constantly check our lives. And because never can tell, maybe God is writing another Bible at this time. But if he was to write another Bible at this time, what would you write about you and I? That is a something that we always need to think about. I pray God will help us to be able to make the right decisions and to position ourselves well in fulfilling God's will for our lives and for our generation in Jesus' name. And perhaps you have listened to this message and you are here to give your life to Jesus, or maybe you are confused and you think you need a divine strategy. I want to tell you that the best person you need in your life is our Lord Jesus. And Jesus Christ, and written in the book of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 8, is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's the one that knows your future. He's the Alpha, he's the Omega. He's the one that is all in all. He's the one that can give you answers to those questions that are brought in your heart. And so if you want to accept Jesus Christ today, I want to assure you that this is the best decision you can ever take. And so you can just pray this prayer, and then you see Jesus coming to your life and to direct liberates you and then fulfilling your purpose in on earth in the name of Jesus. So can you just repeat this prayer after me? Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for agreeing the fact that I'm a sinner. I am confused. I know that I cannot walk in this life by myself. I pray that today you will come into my life. I pray that today you will forgive me all my sins. I also pray that today you write my name in the book of life, and that at the end of the day, when you come to take the sins, I pray that you count me worthy to reign with you in the name of Jesus. I pray that you also help me to be able to reign with you eternally. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. If you have made that prayer with us, we want to congratulate you for making a decision, which is the best choice that anybody can make in this world. And Jesus Christ is the soon coming King, and definitely is going to come back again. So in preparing yourself as you have become born again today, you need to join the Bible Believing Church. You need to ensure that you are constantly with God's people, so that together we all can make heaven. And if you see any question or anything that is still bothering you, you can contact us on the numbers on the last slide of this presentation. And so before we go, we'd like to pray this prayer, and the prayer is, Father, please help me to always position myself in your will and make me the vessel of honor by your mercy. So we pray in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to encourage ourselves. We pray in the name of Jesus that you help us, oh God, to position ourselves well in your will in Jesus' name. We also pray that you help us to remain vessel of honor in all that we do in your vineyard and even in our life in the name of Jesus. Thank you because you have answered. For in Jesus' powerful name we are prayed. Amen. And so once again, we are glad that we are able to encourage ourselves today on front of Second Ambassadors. If you are here to support our channel, I want to encourage you to do that, and so that all of us can grow together as Second Coming of Christ Ambassadors. And so to meet again same time next week, if the Lord Jesus time is coming, we want to wish you all a very wonderful week and a prosperous month of May. Thank you so much. God bless you. Bye.